let us come to the sacrament of communion with open hearts and joyful minds. Let us join first in the prayer of confession that is printed in your bulletin. Old habits and new wrongs wear ruts through our lives and relationships, but God is able to restore us, like water coursing through a desert. The waters of baptism flow through us, reminding us that we belong to God and are raised to new life.
For since God, you love justice,
why then do we persist in wrongdoing and every form of evil? You have given us the gift of your Spirit, why then do we quench the Spirit among us? You have given us the words of the prophets and the Word himself. Why then do we despise and ignore what we have heard from you? You have sent the light into the world. Why then have we loved darkness rather than light? Forgive us, restore us, till and tend us into your garden, until righteousness and praise spring up. For the sake of Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray. In Jesus Christ, the Lord has done great things for us. Even if we have gone out in tears, God brings us home shouting for joy.
In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven.
Each of you gathered here today is invited to share in this feast prepared to celebrate God's abundant love. It is freely given for our spiritual nourishment. You do not have to be sinless. God forgives sin. You do not have to be perfect, for God is perfecting us all. You do not need to belong to this particular church, as God calls all people to this meal. Come to this table not because you must, but because you may. Come to testify not that you are righteous, but that you sincerely love our Lord Jesus Christ and desire to follow him with all your heart. Come in faith and see what God offers you at this table, and then go out and live as a child of God. Let us join now in the sacrament for strength, for courage, for hope, for peace, love. God be with you.
Also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to God.
Let us give thanks to God Most High.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Holy God, our loving Creator, close to us as breathing and distant as the farthest star, we thank you for your constant love and for all you have made us. We thank you for all that sustains life, for all people of faith in every generation, who have given themselves to your will, and especially for Jesus Christ, whom you have sent from your own being as our Savior. We praise you for Christ's birth, life, death, and resurrection, and for the calling forth of your church for its mission in the world. We take courage in the abiding presence of your Holy Spirit in our midst. Gracious God, we ask you to bless this bread and this cup, and make us through this meal, make us the body of Christ, the church, your servant people, that we may be the salt and light and leaven for the furtherance of your will in this world. On the night on which he was betrayed, our Lord took the bread and after giving thanks, broke it, saying, "This is my body, broken for you. Take and eat in remembrance of me." Likewise, on the night in which our Lord was betrayed, he took the cup and said, "This is the new covenant in my blood. Drink it in remembrance of me, for as often as you eat of this meal and drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes again." Could I ask the deacons to please come forward?
Thank you.
forget anyone? I bet we didn't.
No, we didn't.
We didn't. I'm just checking. I didn't think we did, but I didn't want to drop the ball. The gifts of God for the people of God come, for all things are ready. Join together in the prayer of thanksgiving printed in your bulletin. We give you thanks, O God, for having renewed and refreshed us.